Payoh, so today we'll be doing a pre-CH-B06 deck profile. So basically this is featuring CMD's Messiah deck. So let's go on to the deck profile. So for the starter we have Neon Messiah, it has Pioneer, and then the ability Generation Break 1. Put this unit to the soul. During the turn where this card is being unlocked, you may pay the cost. If you do search your deck for a grade 3 card with Messiah in name, put it to your hand and then shuffle the deck. Yep, so that's the starter. So we'll move on to the G zone. G Guardians, we have 2 Lacrina's Karina, 1 Destiny Guardian, one Demon Maxwell, and one of these Cray Elemental card. So from this Cray Elemental card, what it does is when it's placed onto a Guardian Circle, you may drop a card and then draw a card. Next is Demon Maxwell. When it's placed onto a Guardian Circle, choose one card from your back row and lock it. If you do, this unit gets 5k shield, so it's a 20k card if you were to lock. Next is my favorite card, Destiny Guardian. What Destiny Guardian does is unlock 2 cards. If you do, this card gets 10k. Next is Lacrina's Karina. What it does is counter blast 1. Free part 1 G Guardian. When it's placed onto a Guardian Circle, choose up to 3 of your units and lock it. And for each card that you lock, your opponent chooses one card from the back row and lock. Yeah, so that's for the G Guardian. We'll move on to G Zone. So 1 GB8. So what the GB8 does is, once per turn, Generation Break Hand, count Blast 1 and drop 2 cards. For each of your damage zone, your opponent calls one card from his hand to an open Rearguard Circle as lock. Yeah, so that's what it does. Next is 1 X-Lix Messiah. So what X-Lix does is counter blast 1 and flip up an Amnesty Messiah. So
but you must have MST based up. You must already have an MST based up to pay the cost.
Oh, okay. So you flip up Amnesty. Next is the effect. If you have 1 Amnesty face up in the G zone, you will pay the cost. If you do, unlock any amount of cards. For each of your unlocked opponent cards, you retire them. Next is for each of your own unlocked cards, they get 3k each. Then if you unlock 3 or more cards, it gets 1 critical. So this is a Messiah that clears your opponent field. Yeah. Next is 2.
What is this Messiah? I don't know what.
Water Messiah? I don't know. Okay, so what it does is Generation Break 2, Counter Blast 1, and Persona Flip. After that, when it's placed onto the Vanguard Circle, everything becomes opposite effect. So all cards on the field that is not locked, it becomes locked. While other cards that are being locked becomes unlocked. So it becomes opposite. And you must have a Messiah heart. Yeah. Next is 4 Flageolet. So what Flageolet does is counter blast 1 and flip up any G unit, and then during the turn when this unit attacks, you may unlock any amount of cards. If you don't when this unit attacks, for each face up Flageolet in the field, for each face up Flageolet in the G zone, you may unlock 2 cards. And then if you unlock 1 or more, you may choose up to any amount of locked cards and then Omega lock them. Next is, if you unlock 3 or more cards, it gets 1 crit. So during the first turn, you will have to flip itself up, and then for the rest, you can use for another 2 turns to flip up other G-units. Yeah. Next is 3 Amnesty Messiah. What Amnesty does is, counter blast 1, during the turn where this attacks, you may unlock any amount of cards. If you do, this card gets 3k for each unlocked card. And then after that, if you unlock 3 or more, it gets 1 crit. So that's for the G unit. Now we move on to Grade 3s. Grade 3s is 4 Alter Ego Messiah and 3 Freeze Ray. Freeze Ray is there for its second effect. When you take a damage, you may lock one of your opponent's rear guards. So this is to prevent additional attacks as well. Next is the Limit Break 4. During the turn when you lock a card, it gets 3k. So it becomes 13k if you Limit Break and take 1 damage. Next is Alter Ego Messiah. What it does is Generation Break 2, so Blast 1. During the turn where a card gets unlocked, you may draw a card. Next is Counter Blast 1 and lock one of your own units. During the turn where you perform a G unit with Strike, you may pay the cost. If you do, lock one of your opponent's units and choose one unit plus 1k or itself. Oh, the Vanguard itself plus 4-2. So the 5k only belongs to the Vanguard. So it's a 31k if you solo whack. So that's for the grade 3s. Grade 2s, they run 4 Arrestor Messiah, 4 of this card, and then 4 Awakening Messiah. So what Awakening does is during the turn, generation break 1, during the turn where this unit is unlocked, you may choose one card from your field and stand it, and it gets 2k. Next is this card, generation break 1, Carnal Blast 1, and lock itself. During the turn, after the battle that this unit attacks, you may lock this card. If you don't choose another unit, it gets 5k. Next is Arrestor Messiah. What Arrestor does is generation break 1. When it's placed on the rearguard circle, you may have it. If you have a grade 3 or greater Messiah Vanguard, you may have it 2k plus 2k. After that, it gains the effect. After this unit's battle, lock this card. If you do choose one, any of fighters, choose one of any fighters' rearguards in the back row and lock it. So that's the grade 2. Now we'll move on to grade 1s. 4 Destiny Dealer. 4 Sacrifice. 2 Chameleon. And 4 Cosmo Ref. So what Cosmo Ref does is, when this unit is placed onto a gun circle from hand, you may choose one card and drop it. If you do, you may choose your Vanguard and the attack is verified. And then if you have another Cosmo Ref in the drop zone, you may counter charge one. Next is Chameleon, generation break 1, when this unit is being unlocked, you may counter charge 1. So this is normally combo when you strike a Messiah or you use Arrestor to combo. Next is Sacrifice Messiah, generation break 1, lock this unit. During the turn where a card is being locked, if you have a grade 3 or greater Vanguard with Messiah, you may counter charge 1 and then choose another unit plus 3k. Next is Destiny Dealer, basically it's a strike folder. When it's placed onto the rearguard circle from hand, show a grade 3 card to your opponent from hand and then search your deck for an Alter Ego unit. Grade 3 or greater card with grade 3 card with Alter Ego in name. Show it to your opponent and hold it to your hand. Then drop one card and shuffle your deck. Next is during the turn when you want to perform strike, these cards grade get added by 2. So that's for the grade 1. Grade 0s. They run 4 Blink Messiah, 4 Star Vader Paradigm Shift Dragon, 4... I don't know what is it, and 4 Lacrinus Carina. So Lacrinus Carina is when you G-Guard for, we call this specific G-Guardian, which is an Evolve Cell, you may pay the cost to Soul Blast 1. If the amount of face down cards in your damage zone is 1 or less, you will pay the cost if you do counter charge 1. Next is this card. Basically, Spring Theory does is it's a Magal clone. So you go in, so choose one unit plus 3k. It's to mainly be a second option to fill up the soul for Alter Ego first effect. Next is Paradigm. The effect is there for to shuffle when your deck is lower or increase the chance of getting triggered. But the effect is, return this back to your deck. If you have a Star Vader Vanguard and there's a lock card on your opponent's field, you may choose one of your opponent's unit in the back row and lock it. Next is Blink Messiah. Blink Messiah skill is during the turn where your Vanguard with a grade 3 or greater Vanguard with Messiah in it attacks, you may put this to your soul. If you do, draw one card and then it gets 5k. Yep. If you guys enjoy the deck profile of the Messiah deck, do like, share, and comment, and subscribe to my channel, and do tell us what you guys want to see next in the comment section down below. We'll see you guys next time. Bye!